Does it says oil companies should take proactive steps towards mitigation in their day-to-day operations and try to work together to reduce the footprint of plastic wastes.
I also encourage you to collectively work together to reduce plastic footprint by cutting down the use of single-use plastic, but also support the innovation technologies.
Most of the oil and gas activities are being carried out within the country's biodiversity areas, like in the Murchison Falls Park and on the shores of Lake Albert, which should be left unharmed.
We therefore ensure that the oil and gas operators undertake biodiversity initiatives that promote harmonious coexistence of petroleum activities and biodiversity.
We need to implement effective waste management systems. We should invest in infrastructure to support recycling, ensuring that plastics are collected, sorted, and recycled properly. But it's not enough to stop pollution. We must also restore what has been lost.
Isaac Ntuju, the head of oil and gas in the National Environmental Management Authority, NEMA, and other leaders have warned the public on environmental degradation.
Reduce the amount of virgin plastics that you are putting into the environment or that you are getting on board. But also, manage the plastics that you inevitably need to use or need to make use of.
Our responsibility to ensure protection, preservation, and most importantly, promotion of our environment.
How I wish we adopted a culture of planting trees at every precious moment, or at every moment we celebrate.
Some of the representatives from the oil companies like Total Energies and Sinopec says that efforts have been made to mitigate plastic waste in their areas of operation.
Naturally, the reasons of the life are Earth. We rely on lakes, soils, forests, and oceans for sustenance, providing us with food and water for our daily requirements.
We continue to allege and say that we shall support all activities that give, whether national or international, in a bid to see that we comply with all the environment practices.
The Bunyoro Kitara Kingdom Minister for Diaspora, Philip Katahoire, who represented the Prime Minister of the Kingdom, has stressed the need to sensitize the communities about environmental protection.
We are even suggesting the mayors should put there some bylaws where it is illegal to drop anything like plastics in the soil, in the rivers, in the streets, because it's a bad culture.
According to a UN report, more than 400 million tons of plastic are produced every year worldwide, half of which is designed to be used only once, and less than 10% is recycled. An estimated 19 to 23 million tons end up in lakes, rivers, and sea annually. 500 indigenous tree species have also been planted in the districts of Hoima and Bulisa in celebration of a combined World Environment and Biodiversity Days. Story compiled by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news in Hoima.